Welcome to Jason Santana, where I chronicle my fitness journey using a variety of different methods in my one-year work series. My mission is to break the public persona of being transfixed in one style of fitness. Mix it up, have fun, let's accomplish these goals together. What up, what up? It's Jason Santana bringing you episode 74 of my one-year work series titled Deload Week Back. So without further ado, ready? Meet me at the next set. Go! Alright, and that concludes episode 74, Deload Week Back. Now, as the title implies, this is going to be my deload week, and I'll tell you why I chose to make this week a deload week. And that is because when I was in the gym, man, I've noticed, and you know, very recently, like, I started getting addicted to trying to max everything, especially during leg day, whether that was squats or deadlifts. You know, presses, anything that had to do with legs, man, I couldn't help myself. I just wanted to continue just maxing everything, you know? Eventually, that's not going to do anything but lead to injury. So I noticed just the other day, my last leg day, and before I even get in there, I told myself, I'm only going to do, you know, just whatever this amount of weight was. And then I get to that weight, and then I added more weight to it. And I was like, yo, like, what the hell? Control, right? Gains is not just a physicality, man. It's what goes on inside. You know, you can conquer 1,000 men in battle, but if you don't conquer yourself, everything else is meaningless. I just found that a little interesting. I got addicted to wanting to continuously surpass my max. And yeah, I was doing it, but you know, like with the deadlifts specifically, I think that may have been the catalyst for it. Like when I wasn't able to go back and deadlift my 315, and then a week later I did it, and then a week after that I added another 20 pounds, and I just kept on wanting to do that. And you know, with my history of just being active throughout my entire life, I know enough. Oh man, there's a hummingbird at my 11 o'clock. I want to get it, but damn, let me see if I can get it. Hold on. Steph. I know you're gonna appreciate that one. I finally caught it on camera. But yeah, we'll worry. Now, since I'm only averaging about one video per week, you guys are only probably gonna see this one. I'll maybe record another one at the end of this week, but just because you may only get one or two videos, it does not mean that I'm not sticking true to what the deload week is supposed to consist of. And that is literally, I'm taking it easy. I'm doing everything 100% technical. You know, proper technique, proper form, everything. Low weight, high rep. However many workouts you conduct during that week, it's not gonna be anything crazy, anything heavy. Sometimes you gotta take a step back, assess everything that's going on, and, you know, not lose focus, but allow your body to catch up, you know, allow the healing process to catch up. So that way you can make those gains, but at a safer foundation. And it's gonna benefit you in the long run. That's what I'm hoping to accomplish with this deload week. And not only that, but you know, get a little more control of this right here. But yeah, you guys look up deload weeks, do your own research. They are important to the overall gain and longevity to your exercise lifestyle. And with that being said, any questions, comments, concerns, leave them below. And I will see you when you meet me at the next set. Boom!